Hello students, welcome to class 10 English. I am Sharada Enugala, postgraduate teacher. I work for Telangana State Model School, Husnabad. As you are stepping into class 10, you have 8 units in class 10, and under each unit there are 3 readings, reading A, B and C. So today I am going to teach you unit 1, reading A, and again under reading A, it is attitude is altitude, just it's only part 1. First, let's discuss or let me explain you the unit theme, personality development. As you can see in face sheet of your textbook in page number 1, here is a picture, and you can see in the slide also the picture. A boy is sitting over a pencil and flying high in the sky. Like a bird into greater height. It means he is developing himself in all the areas, not only in education. But also, a person needs all-round development to become a good citizen. So, this all-round development is called personality development. So, what is the concept of this personality development? It has gained currency in the last few decades. Nowadays, to work in any organization, it's better you have the talent, skills, your subject knowledge, but personality is the main trait which you need to succeed in your life. So what is that personality? So the children of your age think that personality means growing into height or becoming healthy or just stout or lean. That is personality. It's not that. Personality covers many traits. It's about the positive attitude, about the behavior, about discipline, sincerity. All this comes under personality. So it is a concept, has its roots in the need of making better, mature human beings. It helps people understand themselves and their strengths and weakness, and to form right towards the life, society, career and so on. The individual who has the right attitude towards problems will always accept them courageously and tries to find solutions from the constructive side. As we are in class 10, generally the class 10 students at their age are sensitive to so many things in their surroundings. It is hoped that they draw inspiration from the cases of people who struggled with adversities. What are adversities facing? The difficult situations. And finally succeeded. More than anything, the very concept, personality development, helps the learners take success and failures as matters of fact. The present society witnesses absence of courage, presence of greed among certain people. It is envisaged that this unit will give the exposure to a science of living. The three texts included under this theme, personality development, are Attitude is Altitude, you can see here, Reading A, Reading B, Every Success Story is a Story of Great Failures, Reading C, I Will Do It. So here, coming to Reading C, maybe a story, narrative, or its biographical sketch, very interesting. So all the students, it's must that you must expose yourself to extensive reading. So you can take this Reading C as your extensive reading. Before your teachers explain you this Reading C, you have to read this one so that you can derive a lot of pleasure, you can understand very well. In that way you can develop your reading skill. It's very good enough. And now let us go into our lesson, Reading A, Attitude is Altitude. So here are the two words, attitude and altitude. What is attitude? Behavior comes under attitude, character comes under attitude, sincerity, discipline, these are all the traits, and these are called as the personality traits. Coming to altitude, what is altitude? Generally, the general meaning is height above the sea level. So, how these two words are connected to both? Attitude is altitude. If you have good attitude, developing yourself in all the traits, then you can go into a great extent in your life, into the highest altitude in your life. So here, coming to the next, what is covered under this lesson, in the page number 2, you have some pictures. The first picture is of Sudha Chandran, Stephen Hawking, Helen Keller. So here you can see these are all the eminent personalities, eminent people in the world. Despite of their disability, they succeeded in their life. Then who is this Sudha Chandran? She is an Indian. And you can see clearly in the picture that she is dressed in a traditional dress and a classical dancer, Bharatanatyam dancer, we can see clearly. But here is a great story about her. You know very well about Stephen Hawking, a renowned scientist, physicist, and Helen Keller is a good teacher. Just I'll be wrapping up in 2 to 3 minutes of each eminent personality here. Coming to Sudha Chandran. Sudha Chandran is an Indian film and television actress and an accomplished Bharatanatyam dancer. In 1981, she hurt her leg in a road accident near Tiruchirappalli, Tamil Nadu while coming back from Madras with her parents. Her leg was amputated and replaced with an artificial leg. You can see here the artificial leg. Even though she became an established Bharatanatyam dancer, started her career with a Telugu film Mayuri, which was based on her own life and was awarded the 1986 Special Jury Award at National Film Awards. She is a successful person in her career. See, even though she lost her leg, she didn't stop her career. With a lot of self-confidence, she has led her life and she developed her career, future. So that is not an obstacle for her. Any disability must not become an obstacle. She succeeded in her life, Sudha Chandra. Next, Stephen Hawking, you know very well about Stephen Hawking. Stephen William Hawking was an English theoretical physicist, cosmologist, and author known for his work with black holes and relativity, and also author of popular science books like A Brief History of Time and many other books. At the age 21, while studying cosmology at University of Cambridge, he was diagnosed with amyotrophic lateral sclerosis. So you can see, if you Google and read the biography of Stephen Hawking, you can see some more pictures that he will be always sitting in a something like electric wheelchair. That is some type of paralysis, stroke. Even though he did not stop his career, he was very much interested in physics and study of cosmosis. That's why he researched on black holes. So despite of these adversities, he had done research on black holes. You can read further about Sudha Chandran and Stephen Hawking in Google. So it also becomes an extensive reading for you. Coming to Helen Keller. So this lady, Helen Keller, was an American author, political activist and lecturer. She was the first deaf and blind person to earn a Bachelor of Arts degree. She was contracted an unknown illness. The illness left her both deaf and blind. Even though she was graduated, she authored nearly 12 books. Means she wrote nearly 12 books and became a famous teacher in the world. Despite of that disability, not disability means at the age of 19 months old, she lost her eyes and she had become deaf, even though she did not stop. So here she inspired many people and delivered many inspirational speeches. So children, you have been watching number of disabled people here and how they succeeded in life. Now here in our reading A, attitude is altitude, we are going to learn about Nick Vujicic. So here the next slide is the glossary. So when I teach you the lesson, you come across some words and later on also you can see the glossary. the slides like this. Nearly 20 words are here for you to for easy learning. Let's go into the lesson. Attitude is altitude. The lesson starts like this. Imagine having no arms to stretch in the morning to help you scratch that itch, to allow you to wrap your arms around your loved ones. Imagine having no legs to kick pebbles down the street, to walk or run, to bicycle or skateboard, or get you from point A to point B. Then imagine both at once, which is what Nik Vujicic has faced his whole life. Have you heard something like this before? So here, in reading A, attitude is altitude, we are going to learn about a famous person, Nik Vujicic. His full name is Nicholas James Vujicic, who faced many problems because he is not having arms to stretch. See here, the starting lines we can see. Imagine having no arms to stretch in the morning. You know what is stretch? To help you scratch that itch, to allow you to wrap your arms around your loved ones. Generally what we do early in the morning when we get up from the bed, you move to your parents and just give a hug to them. Just you wrap your hands over your loved ones, around your loved ones. So when imagine that if you don't have any arms to do like that, it's very a sad moment for everyone, especially for children. Imagine having no legs to kick pebbles. So when you are a child, when you are a boy or girl, while walking on the road, you just like to kick pebbles. What are pebbles? Pebbles are the stones down the street to walk or run. If there are no arms and no legs, it's very difficult to walk or run. To bicycle, to skateboard, or get you from point A to point B means to travel from one place to move from one place to another place. Then imagine both at once, if there are no arms and no legs, which is what Nik Vujicic has faced his whole life. Nik has no arms and no legs. He has faced his whole life like that. Have you heard something like this before? Have you seen any person like this before? So now in this lesson, we are going to learn about this great person who has become a great inspiration to all the people in the world despite of his disability. So this is the part one of reading A. In the next session, I'm going to deal part two of reading A.